Today I'm at the Shanghai Astronomy Museum. And apparently the first thing they want to show about astrophysics is a huge pendulum. Cool. Unlike most museums in Shanghai, this one's not in the city center. It's in Lingang, near where I live. So, didn't have to go very far to get here today. Ooh, this is cool. Somehow I feel like I'm riding Space Mountain right now. Oh, now you can't see very much. Oh, no. Is that thing turning into like a modern Earth? I think maybe it is. I think so. Ah, yes, here it is. I think this is supposed to be an Earth here with continental drift, and I'm guessing we're having an ice age now? How interesting. Fun. Really fun. And here's the contemporary Earth with lights from modern civilization. Maybe you can see the Nile Delta there. Oh, and now it's turned back into daytime. This is fun. A model of the Earth orbiting the Sun and the Moon orbiting the Earth. Ooh, a little eclipse there. And a model of how people think the moon was formed, with a huge object crashing into Earth and like scattering dust everywhere that eventually forms into a moon. How interesting. Here it is with a fully formed moon and like a semi-formed one here. Models of the sun here. This is a really popular museum and it's new, so that's why there's so many people here. And over here we got the planets of the solar system. Sorry, Pluto didn't get in. I wonder if they have a dwarf planet display somewhere. Jupiter! And its great red spot that's as big as Earth. Oh! Well, now it's gone. This must be a terrestrial planet. Mars, I'm guessing? It's more like Mars than Venus to me, but I'm not so sure. It's over here. Ooh. So they're saying this is Venus, actually. I wonder if that other one was actually Venus and not Mars. I've never been really clear about what the surface of Venus looks like. Here's Saturn and its rings. And this is Io, one of Jupiter's moons. I've often thought it would be really amazing to go to a Jovian moon and then watch Jupiter rise in the mornings. Just a dream, to be clear. I don't imagine that travel to the Jovian moons is going to be possible within my lifetime. But who knows? Here are some meteorites collected from the desert. And some collected in Antarctica. Here's the Milky Way Galaxy. yellow dot is the solar system. That's what it says in Chinese there. I would think that should be nebulae, right? But, oh well. This section seems to have something to do with ancient astronomy. And architecture that relates to the heavenly bodies, like Stonehenge. Interesting. Oh, that is kind of cool. It says it's a cuneiform tablet. How interesting. Ancient Greek astronomy. Cool. Copernicus and all of his ideas, his realizations about why there was planetary retrograde motion and stuff like that. Cool. Very interesting history here. Never forget it, everyone. William Herschel discovered Uranus. Yes, I really pronounce it Uranus most of the time, but one does have to joke occasionally. Mount Wilson, that's near home for me. Too cool. Ooh, cool space telescopes. And earthbound telescopes. The Hubble! Oh, this stuff is too cool. Space. I love that name, just extremely large telescope. Very descriptive. Ooh, space flight. Rocket designers, you got Van Heflin Paun up there, and that's Chen Shenshen. Really sad story there. He was in the US for a long time, but then people started suspecting him of being a communist just basically because he was Chinese. Really not a great story. Ooh, we've got the, got Yuri Gagarin here. Yang Liwei, one of the more famous Chinese astronauts. Oh, and there's Laika, the space dog, who they just let die when she re-entered the Earth. How mean. Oh, Neil Armstrong here. And here's a Chinese moon lander and moon rover called the Jade Rabbit. It's named for the legend of the Jade Rabbit that belonged to Chang'e, the woman in the moon. And over here we've got Mars rovers. Too cool. And look, a space module. Kind of fun that from here at the space module you can look down on the Earth. And even the moon model there, too cool. Here we are in the space module, absolutely full of people. Ooh, cool. A little exercise bike. Probably be good to keep your body in shape while you're up in zero gravity, huh? Oh, here's somebody using it. I guess this must be one of the Chinese space modules that they've made. Ooh. Looks like a space shower. How do space showers work without gravity? I actually don't know. Assuming that's actually what this is. Some satellites here over the Earth. Certainly seems we'll never run out of things to explore as long as there's anything like a humanity to explore it. Interesting. This part's about like the electromagnetic spectrum, including visible light. And how it relates to astronomy and understanding starlight. Ooh, this is fun. They got a little animation here showing a future where the Andromeda galaxy and the Milky Way galaxy collide. Together to make the Milkomeda galaxy. Well, Milkomeda is a really funny name. Ooh, confusing stuff like dark matter. Wow, that is confusing. I do not understand any of this stuff. I am not a scientist. The essence of gravity. This section seems to be mostly about gravity and how it shapes the universe. Oh, a bit of different stellar types. Black holes. Ooh, and what are these stars? They're evolving into, are those red giants? Whoa, is that a supernova? I think that might be a supernova. Wow. Your star explode. Cool nebulae. Ooh. Ooh, curved space time. Being shown on the floor by, ooh, it follows the people. How weird. Oh my. I've heard about this, but I'm just not a scientist. Not even close. Ugh. This stuff makes my head hurt a little bit. It's just so complicated. Wow. Got Albert Einstein and his theory of relativity here. Very young Einstein in some of these pictures. That's more how we always remember him. This is an interesting display. It's supposed to turn the entirety of cosmic history into a single year. So that here, in January, this is where the universe began. Like, I think we're about to see it start again. Yeah, I guess that's the Big Bang there, they say. And then there's more of this chaotic universe going on through the next few months with, like, nothing akin to modern, to the modern solar system. Or Earth. Still more stars here. So the sun only shows up here in August. And the Earth in September. By October, only like germs have appeared as far as life goes. Even in November. And like everything we know of Earth, even dinosaurs, they show only in December. These numbers, they're too big for humans to make sense of, I feel like. I guess displays like this help a bit. Here's an interesting topic. Just the astronomical scales. Like how far the sun is from the nearest other star. How far even the planets are apart from each other. How far the sun is from the center of the Milky Way. And even the distance from the Milky Way to the Andromeda Galaxy. Really far. Those are megaparsecs. Here's kiloparsecs. Parsecs are even bigger than light years. Not by much. Well, yeah, by much. I mean, it's 3 times as large as a light year. So it's not orders of magnitude bigger than a light year, but it's still big. This sector is interesting. It talks about how we think there must be a force called dark energy, but we don't really understand it well yet. And here's another section that has a similar point of questioning, which is still that we understand that the Big Bang Theory explains a lot, but that there's a lot that we don't understand about it yet. Science marches on, I guess. This is going to show how big the universe is by slowly expanding. Hide from a hydrogen atom to DNA to a neuron to a human to the Earth to the solar system. To the Milky Way galaxy, the galaxy cluster, all the way out here to the observable cosmos. And it makes a point of saying the observable cosmos is not the entire cosmos, it's just the part we can observe. Wow. From outside the museum, you can see a huge dome, and here it is. On the inside of the museum. And that will just about do it for today at this museum. And unlike when leaving most museums, I will not be going to the metro now. I can just get a car or a bus home. And here it is from the outside with its big dome as we leave. Hope you enjoyed this visit to the Shanghai Astronomy Museum. If you did and you want to see more of my life in China, this would be a great time to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.